In this video, we'll work through the steps used to create the worksheet and data input used in the chart activity in the Connections Excel 2013 manual. As you can see, the completed worksheet is shown. I'm going to duplicate the original below so that you can see the steps I use. It'll only take a minute or two because we're going to let Excel do some of the work for us. The first thing I'm going to do is create one cell from the four cells using the merge command. This is entirely for looks. The chart will work fine without this step. It just looks more professional. Step one is to click cell B8 and drag to E8. Once all four cells are selected, I'm going to right-click and select Merge and Center from the menu to create one cell from the four with a formatting of center, which just applies to the placement of the text in the middle of the box. I'm going to now type in 2013. Then I'll repeat the process by clicking F8 and dragging to I8. This time I'll merge and center using the command on the Home tab in the Alignment command group. Then I'll type in 2014. Next I'm going to cell B9 and type in Q1. Q1 stands for quarter one, or the first quarter, referring to the financial year, the first 3 months of a financial year. Then I'm going to use the fill handle to drag all the way across to I9. Notice that Excel is really smart. There can only be four quarters in a period, so it knows to repeat Q1 through Q4 rather than go up to Q8, which wouldn't make any sense. Excel just saved us some time. Next, I'm going to add sales, expenses, and profit by typing them in on the left side. Excel will use all of these labels on the chart that we will create in a moment. Now I'm going to add the numbers for sales and expenses. I'm just going to click in the first cell, B10, type in 4, and then use either the tab key or the right arrow key to move right to the next cell, type in the number, and just keep doing that. It's quite fast. Now we want to do something different for the profit row. We want to add and use a formula rather than typing in the answers. We want to let Excel do the work. If the numbers for sales or expenses should change for any reason, Excel will automatically update the totals if you've used a formula. Plus, all we have to do is enter one formula and then we'll let Excel do the rest. I'm going to click cell B12 to select it, then go up to the formula bar and type in an equal sign. That equal sign tells Excel that we are going to enter a formula rather than data or text. Now I can type in the cell that I want, but the easier way is just to click the cell and let Excel enter it into the formula. So I'm going to click cell B10. See how Excel added it to the formula bar? Now I need a mathematical operator or symbol. In this case, we want to subtract, so I'm going to just type in the minus sign or the dash on your keyboard and click cell B11, and Excel will enter B11 and complete the formula. Now if I press the enter key on my keyboard, you'll see that Excel completes the math function and shows me the result in the cell. Notice, however, that the formula still appears in the formula bar. It will always appear in the formula bar, but it will always show the result in the cell. We'll use the power of Excel to finish the sequence. Click cell B12 to select it, then drag the fill handle to the right to I12. Excel knows that you want to fill the cells with the formula, but replace the cells with each column's data. Now for the chart. We have to select the complete data set that we want the chart to display. We could use either set of data, but let's take the top set and select the range A1 to I5. When they are all selected, you'll see them highlighted. Now let's make the chart. On the Insert tab in the Charts command group, click Recommended Charts. Excel will display the chart it thinks best matches your data set. In this case, the clustered column chart style. Click the graphic to select it. And voila, there's your chart. Notice that the chart used the labels you created to sort and display the data in an easy to understand graphic. And note that the charts are not bound to a cell. They float over the worksheet.